As part of the 100th anniversary of the Peace Palace, a ministerial conference on peaceful dispute solutions was held in the palace.
It's a symbol of justice because for over 100 years, international decisions settling disputes between states have been rendered in the Peace Palace. First, permanent court of arbitration, and for the last 91 years, two international courts, permanent court of international justice, and then since 1946, international court of justice, which is the principal judicial organ of the United Nations.
During the conference, the importance of resolving disputes peacefully were examined.
We need to encourage countries to recognize the ICJ's compulsory jurisdiction. As members of the United Nations, we recognize the ICJ as a principal organ of the United Nations. In our view, recognizing its jurisdiction is a logical and necessary next step. Secondly, we must help countries realize how useful and flexible arbitration is as a way of settling disputes. The Security Council and the General Assembly could draw parties' attention to this instrument more often, and perhaps we should also advocate it more in the public debate. Finally, we must reduce the obstacles to the peaceful settlement of disputes by making alternatives like mediation available.
The minister also spoke with influential bloggers from all over the world.
Perhaps also in the educational system in your country, that in schools and universities people could be taught what it is the court does.
It is a splendid occasion to underline the importance of the activities that take place in the Peace Palace to obtain peace and justice in the world, as the Foreign Minister has said, and the Secretary General of the United Nations have both stressed that importance. It's only once every 100 years, so maybe it's an idea to do it more often.
The results of this conference will be used in order to prepare for the General Assembly of the United Nations held at the end of September.